Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to talk about interesting CSS library called NES.css. This video will show you how to turn your website into 8-bit style in a couple minutes with this library. Ready? Let's check it out. There are two ways to install this library. If you want to get the CSS file and host it yourself, get it from npm or yarn install command. Or you can just include it to your page using CDN like this tutorial. And here is the example page. I already add some basic elements like paragraphs, radio, and checkbox and progress bar. I didn't put on any CSS styles for them at all, only just basic width and margin. We'll let NES library do the rest. First, let's include NES.css to our page from CDN. You will also need to include the font as well. This library does not include the font, so I will just use the Google font. The default recommended font is the Press*2P, but you can change that to others if you like. You will see that the cursor has been changed to NES style as well as the font. Now we can use the library by adding various classes to our element. For example, you can add NES container class to create a container box around the element. Let's try adding it to all divs. With these containers, you can also add title into it by adding withTitle class. Then add title class to the first text element you have. NES.css has many built-in buttons. To use it, just add NES.btn class to any button element. If you want to change the button types, just add additional class to it. For example, you can add isPrimary class to get the blue button, or isWarning for yellow. We can use the same concept for our input fields. I'm going to add NESRadio and NESCheckbox classes to our example elements. Same as input field, let's add NES progress class to our progress bar. One feature that I love about this library is it also has built-in CSS icons for you to use. Just pick whatever you want and copy them to your page. You can also change the icon size by changing isLarge class to isSmall or isMedium. There are lots of other features for you to try out. Check the NES.css project page for the example code. So that's all for this tutorial. Hope you guys like it. As always, don't forget to like or subscribe to our channel to stay tuned for the next update. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!